Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to save and export your logo files for handoff to a client. So I want to go over a few different things, the different file types and what they're used for, best practices for saving your work on your own computer, and then I'll go over what the client is generally looking for when you save these file packages. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I've got my approved logo here, and I'm just going to drag this onto my Illustrator icon to open it. All right, so we have a full color version. We've got a white version. This one has an outline added on. And then we have a black version, or actually it's more dark gray. But anyway, this is the three versions that we'll want to give to our client. And when I hand off a logo to a client, I usually give it to them in a variety of formats. I give them an Illustrator file, a PDF, a JPEG, PNG, SVG, and EPS. First, we'll do the vector format. So this will be AI, EPS, PDF, and SVG. So first up is the Illustrator file. Now I could give it to them just like this, but I find it easier to make one file the way I want it and then just use that file to export all the other file types. So to do that, I'm going to resize my artboard. I usually make it about 400 by 400 pixels, but since this is a more wide logo, I'm going to go ahead and make it skinny. So we'll hit Shift O to get to our artboards tool. That's right over here. And then up here at the top, I'm going to change this to 400 by maybe by 150. And I'm making sure this is not checked, otherwise it'll scale proportionally and we don't want that. By the way, if you're not seeing this panel up here, window control right here. Okay, so this is the right size. Now I'm going to get back on my selection tool. I'm going to just select all of these and move them over, and then I'll select my first logo. I'm going to make sure to group this with Command G or Control G. And then I'm going to position it on that first artboard. I'll open my align panel right over here. Also, all of these windows can be found up here in window also. So here's align. And then I'm going to make sure it's aligned to the artboard right down here. If you're not seeing this part, you can always show options right here. And then I'll choose horizontal align center and vertical align center. Now I'm going to make two more artboards for my other two logos. So I'm going to click the new artboard button twice, and I'm going to get rid of the orange background. So it won't look like anything's on this artboard until you select it. You'll want to make sure that each of these are grouped, as we said before. I actually have a keyboard shortcut that'll align horizontally and vertically to the artboard, so I'm just going to hit that. That will do it. Then I'll click on my next artboard and align this one to that one. If you notice that your artwork is not aligning to the correct artboard, make sure you just click it first, and you can kind of see a black highlight around it, and that's how you'll know that you're on the right artboard. So for example, if we move this and then click this artboard, select it again, and then align, it'll align to that artboard. We select this one, select it again, and then align, it'll align to the correct artboard. So I just wanted to share that with you. That might be an issue that comes up for you. Okay, the next step is to name our artboards. So I'll click on the first one. That'll highlight the artboard over here in my artboards panel. I'll double click that word, whatever it happens to be, and type in color. Now I can just double click and it should bring the next artboard up on my screen. This one is white, and I'll do the same over here. Double click on the word and then change the name. So now my artboards are called color, white, and black. Now renaming your artboards isn't really that important for the Illustrator file, but it's a good thing to do because it makes naming the other file types easier. So let's go ahead and save this file. We'll go to File, Save As, and I'm going to start a new folder out here. I'm going to call it GDH2 Logo, and we'll create. And I'll save this as GDH2 Logo in here. Our format is Adobe Illustrator, and we'll save. And then we'll say OK. Okay, so the Illustrator file is ready to go. Next, we'll save the EPS files. Now, EPS are technically outdated, but if you're handing your files off to a printer who still uses a really old version of Illustrator, you'll need to save them as an older file. Just like with all vector formats, EPS are also scalable, meaning that you can make them as big as you want without losing quality. So let's save as EPS. We'll go to File, Save As, and then we'll come down here and choose Illustrator EPS. This will be in the same folder, GDH2 Logo. Now when we do EPS, we'll want to choose Use Artboards and All here. Okay, and we'll save. And this will bring up the EPS options dialog box. Now, if we want to save this for someone who's using an older version of Illustrator, probably you'll want to go with an Illustrator 10. That is a really old version. It should open on everyone's systems. You'll get this little warning button that just says, hey, this is going to probably outline all your type, might disable some editing features and that kind of thing. And that happens because you're saving to an older format that doesn't support all the new stuff that Illustrator can do these days. So that is okay. We'll say okay. And then we'll say okay again. And now let's go look what happened in our file. We'll open up our folder. And now you can see three different EPS files, and they all have an underscore and then the artboard name after it. So this is really nice. Someone can see at a glance which of the three files it is. Okay, next up is SVG files, and these are also vector files, but they can be used on the web as image files, and that's becoming more and more common. Okay, so let's go to File, Save As, and then we can come down here and choose SVG. Right down here at the bottom. We'll choose Use Artboards for this too, and then we'll save. I usually do SVG Basic 1.1 for this, and we'll say okay. Another thing you'll need to make sure of is that all your text is outlined. So if you need to do that, you can go to Type, Create Outlines right here. Let's see how the SVG file saved. Okay, we've got the black one, we've got the color one, and a white one. Now this white one is probably going to freak out your customers a little bit. So you'll probably need to educate them a little bit about this, that there actually is vector information in this file. And once it's uploaded to the web or whatever, you'll be able to see it just fine. You'll also notice that it has saved the artboard name after each file, which is awesome. Okay, and we have one more file type to save under the vector formats, and that is the PDF file. So we'll go to File, Save As, and we can just save this as PDF. This doesn't give us the option of using artboards because it automatically will use them. So we'll just go ahead and save. And Illustrator default is fine, so we'll save PDF. So here's our PDF file, and it has three pages, one for each design. Let's go ahead and open this in Acrobat. Okay, so you can see the different files. And in this case, I would probably delete this page because usually clients are going to print from a PDF and this is just going to print a blank page, obviously. So I'm going to right click and then just delete the page. And then I'll save this. Moving on to the raster files. For the raster ones, instead of doing File Save As, you'll need to go to File, Export, and then Export As. First we'll do the JPEG. So down here at the bottom, I'm going to change this to JPEG. And we'll use artboards. Then we'll export. Now something to think about is that JPEG files cannot have a transparent background. They can be used for print and web, but we'll be giving the client PNG files specifically for the web, so I'm going to save these JPEG files for print. So for exporting, we're going to have our color model be CMYK, and I'm going to put this at 300 PPI right here, and then we'll say okay. When we come out to our Finder, we can see our black JPEG here, our white one here, and our color one here. Now the white JPEG is pointless because since it doesn't have a transparent background, all it is honestly a white block. So we need to delete this one. I'll go ahead and do that by hitting Command Delete or just dragging it to your trash can on a PC. These other JPEG files will end up at around 5 inches wide at 300 PPI, which is probably way bigger than the client will ever need. And that's a good thing because you can always decrease the size with raster files, but if you increase them past 100%, they're going to be blurry. And I also want to mention that if you bring these files into Photoshop and then view them at greater than 100%, they will look blurry because they are raster files. So just keep in mind, if they look good at 100%, they will print nicely if they're at 300 PPI at 100%. All right, next up is PNG files. So I'm going to go to File, Export, Export As, and then down here we'll choose PNG. We'll need to choose Use Artboards here too. So we'll export this. And then we'll get this dialog box. We want it to be for screen. The main usage for these is going to be web, so 72 PPI is perfect. And then make sure your background color is transparent. And then we'll say okay. So the really nice thing about PNG files is that they don't have a background. So when we look at these, you can see right through them. Okay, so now we have all the files we need to hand off, but I always like to keep them really organized. So to do that, I'm going to back up one. I actually keep a folder with file types inside, so I'm just going to copy all these, and then we'll go back to our GDH2 logo, and I'll paste these in. Now these are all just empty folders with the title EPS, JPEG, etc. Now I'll hit Command 2 on my keyboard. This is only really on a Mac. You can also search by kind, which was what we're going to do on a PC. It's just a little different. So anyway, search by the type of file, and we can just grab all the EPS files and drag them into the EPS folder. Get our two JPEGs. Remember, we did delete one of those. PNG files and SVG. Since these other file types only have one file, I always just leave them out in the folder by themselves. Now this is the file that we'll want to send to our clients, but we need to zip it first. So to do that, we'll come to File, Compress, GDH2 Logo. And now we have a zip file to send off to them. On a PC, I think you need to right click and then do something like Save as Zip or Save as Compressed File or something like that. But there is a way to do this on PC too. And then you can just send this to them via email. Or if the file is too big for email, you can do it with WeTransfer or something like that. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, please hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, thank you.